happy. I thought I'm talking to my. Can we put this down, please? We're foreign roommates. What's the problem?
What's the problem? The problem is it's too late. I can't believe this. What happened? What happened to the whole you being a crutch thing?
Some people might call it a crutch, but what's a crutch? It's support. Support from someone who loves you. Someone who has a terrace, which you don't, out here in Murderville.
Fuck! Well, I was wondering when you'd arrive.
Who are you?
Perfectly well who I am, Alexander.
No, I don't. Who the hell are you and what are you doing in my fucking house?
Honestly, I would think my haunting would have been more impactful on you.
Your haunt? You? You're the asshole who kept on banging on my closet and flickering the lights? Shit, dude, I thought I just lived in a shitty apartment.
Well, we do. I could do so much better.
Haha. Wait, so... if you're a ghost...
Spectre.
Bless you.
That was not a sneeze.
Am I dead?
I don't know, Alexander. Why don't you ask your corpse?
My what? Oh.
Indeed.
Does my hair really look that bad in the back?
That is what you're focused on.
What do you want me to say, dude? I mean, it's kind of obvious how I died.
Hmm. Yes. I didn't know you were that... flexible, Alexander.
Alex, not Alexander.
Percival.
Huh.
What?
Thought it would be more scary, like... Babadook.
Do I look particularly threatening?
Nah, you look like a twink.
Pardon me?
Nothing. What now?
Wait for your body to be found, see what they do with it, then pick a house and start hunting.
Can't I just stay here?
Of course not, this one is mine.
Are you kidding me? This is my house, I paid rent.
I resided here before you bought it, it's my home.
You're an asshole.
And you are a whiny bastard.
I died!
Oh. And do you think I simply was born a phantom?
Jesus Christ, if I had to die, could I have at least had better company than you?
Believe me, it goes both ways.
When did you decide to redecorate?
Will, I live here. And if you're having a problem with the bathroom, you should just say it now.
Let me say this, then. From now on, all pillows and food need to be cleared through me!
So, Percy.
Percival.
Percy, what's there to do while I wait? Any ghost taxes I gotta fill out?
No.
Or, now I know Grace Adler Designs, but, what if we just move the wall, like, 4 feet, and then we'd have equal bathroom?
Look at you. Mr. Compromising. Mr. Not-So-Controlling.
Don't do that, Grace!
Do you do anything for fun?
I used to haunt you. That took up most of the day. Cannot very well do that now, can I?
I'd prefer if you didn't.
Well, when you weren't home, I'd read the newspaper or watch the telly. Although daytime shows aren't very stimulating.
Most TV isn't. Guess I can't change the channel with my meat sack lying on the ground.
Meat sack?
That's what it's called.
What about, I don't know, a body?
Listen, the only way I deal with grief is humor. Let me live.
You're dead, Alexander.
I know. What if no one comes?
What do you mean?
What if no one finds me?
Someone always does. You do not smell pleasant after a while.
Ew. Wait, how do you know that?
I've seen my fair share of corpses in my afterlife. Mine laid in a common tomb, so. I would sit there waiting to see if anyone wished to pay respects.
Did anyone...
No. Prior to my death, my family cut me off.
Well, shit. What did you do that was so scandalous? Wore the wrong gloves to tea?
They found out I was a fairy.
Dude, you're a ghost, not a fairy.
What? Not like that.
What do you mean, then?
A homosexual.
Oh.
Yes.
So, you like...
Yes.
So do I.
I am very much aware.
Was it the porn?
Unfortunately.
Whoops.
In all fairness, you have the most dull taste.
Hey!
Those men you look at are so bland, Alexander.
I can't believe I'm getting roasted for my porn taste coming from a guy who got hot and bothered over an ankle.
I did not.
What's your type then?
What do you mean?
You know.
I do not know. That is why I asked.
God, you're dumb. What type of boys do you like?
What?
That's what type means.
That is none of your business.
We're gonna be stuck here. We might as well get to know each other.
That's too personal.
Would you rather I tell you what boys I like?
No.
I think twinks are hot.
I loathe you.
You adore me. Anyway? I'm sorry.
For?
Pushing you.
Oh. Apology accepted. I apologize for being rude earlier. I should have been more kind. Death is not something to easily get over. I should have been understanding. As a fellow grave man.
Hey, no hard feelings, man.
Come and get it, Will.
No, I'm getting out of here. What the hell am I keeping?
What is your problem? Why are you totally bailing out on this piano?
I'm not. But do I have to play it every second?
Yes, you do. Now sit your ass on the bench of the piano that we bought together. Sip your root beer float.
Hey, I have a question.
What?
Why me?
What do you mean?
Why did you haunt me? I mean, you're old as hell. You could have stuck around almost anywhere, but you chose here. Could have been in a fancy opera place or an old house or an abandoned castle, but you're here.
Well?
Well?
Envy, I believe.
Envy? You were jealous of my broke ass?
No, not the money, but... But your existence, people here, you get to truly live. I haven't lived in decades, Alexander. My life was dinners, studying, and hoping to God my father didn't recognize the green carnation on my lapel. But you get to hold hands with men, flirt, smile, and no one bats an eye. I wasn't allowed to live. Alexander, you lived and lived fully, darling. Of course I was jealous.
Percy,
And it's not just that, but so much more. You joke, you laugh, dance, breathe. All the things I took for granted. I saw you do everything I wanted and felt maybe if I stayed, if I wasn't cowardly for once and simply told myself happiness is something I'm allowed, something that wasn't revoked because of what I am. I saw men, saw them invade secret clubs, be beat bloody for holding a hand, saw them suffer for simply chasing happiness, Alexander. And sometimes I wonder where their phantoms haunt. Where did they go after they were punished? Why am I the only one left, doomed to haunt shitty apartments and watch what I could never have?
I don't know.
Of course you don't.
But when I was alive, I knew that, the universe works in weird ways. You know, that everything happens for a reason. God, I was never really good at cheering people up, but even if I don't know where all those other people are, and if we're stuck together in my shitty apartment with Will and Grace in the background forever, at least we have each other. I don't know. I liked having you as my ghost. It was different. I liked that. I like you, personally. And about the gay thing, we're gay, and that's okay. God, I sound like a chicken soup for the soul. For an actual soul. God, that's stupid. You don't even know what that is. I'm sorry.
I don't be.
Hey, I bet your parents would be pretty pissed if they could see you now, and that's like screwing it to the man in a way, huh?
Why would they be upset?
Well, I mean, it's late. The moon is high. The TV is on the gayest sitcom from the late 90s, and you're sitting with a pretty cute dude, if I do say so myself.
Alexander, are you propositioning me?
Dude, call me Alex. Seriously.
It's improper.
Really?
Yes.
It's a shame. Pretty sure you know I don't give a shit about propriety, Percy.
Oh my. That was...
What? Was that not what they did back in the old days? Should I have bowed and offered you flowers?
As a matter of fact, yes.
That's pretty archaic of you, dude.
Maybe so.
So? Welcome to the afterlife, Percy. How do you like it?
I wish I could have done that when I was alive.
Dude, with who?
Why do I care for you?
My sunny personality, my good looks, my sense of humor.
You are adequate.
Hey, Percy?
Yes?
You were already punished enough, okay? Your life was already hell. Make your afterlife heaven.
I'm gonna propose a toast to family. Family that loves you and accepts you for exactly who you are. Bold.